For a photo shoot very quickly.
You know that. Thank you. Thank you, my brother.
Who are you?
Thanks, guys. There you do.
Sorry. He's coming over here.
I'm sorry, the white corner, right underneath the Gleason Gym sign.
Daniel, it's the topic of the conversation throughout the whole week. It's been your weight. How are you right now with the 157 catch weight dawning on Friday?
I'm going good. I've had to do it hard throughout the training camp, but I've got a great team that backed me up 100%. And I knew what I had to do. I knew it wasn't going to be easy throughout. This definitely suits Kodo and his team, but it's part of the contract. We're going to do it.
Now, has it ever crossed your mind, being that there's no financial penalty and coming in overweight? I know you're a consummate professional, but having that advantage, being that the fight is Saturday, and I'm sure Cotto's not going to cancel, to maybe come in between 157 and 160.
That wasn't what I had in mind. I'll work with my team, and whatever my team recommends to me, I'll do, but at this stage, they've asked me to make 157, so.
Do you think this might be like an Austin Trout situation where Miguel Cotto might be looking ahead of you with Canelo at the end of the year, as he did in 2012 when Austin Trout was his opponent and he lost to Austin Trout and lost that Canelo fight?
I do believe that, but I guess with all the attention that the media gives this, Cotto will be looking at taking me on more serious. It's my life, as do I. I'm focused on not winning this fight. To me, it's not about ruining their plans. And people have spoken about that. To me, it's about winning this fight. I want to win the WBC World Title. That's what they call it.
How many days for this fight?
Feeling good. I've done everything in training camp. My coach is happy, which is the main thing. I'm happy. So it's all about getting the mind right. The body's in great shape. So I need to get in. It's going to be a great fight. Miguel Cotto always comes to fight, and I come to fight as well. And I'm going to use my best abilities against his, and I'm sure it's going to be an action-packed fight.
Daniel, what about Cotto having that rematch clause in the contract? Does that say anything to you?
There's been a few little things that that have been brought to my attention that probably do say little bits and pieces, but I'm not looking too deeply into those things. My main goal is to not worry about the fine details. My goal is to win the fight.
Can you give a shout out to the people in Australia? I know your family and your children. Give a shout out to them.
Just send my love to my family, my wife, my kids. I've got a 7-week-old baby at home.
How old?
7 weeks.
7 weeks.
7 weeks. Yeah, she's only a baby, and my three other kids back home as well, waiting, and they've been missing me for over 3.5 weeks now, and I can't wait to get home and bring the title and show them.
Right, Cotto is going to be in that Puerto Rican Day parade. If you win on Saturday, are you going to steal his float?
Yeah, he's the Grand Marshal.
Oh, you going to be the Grand Marshal?
Yeah, he's the Grand Marshal.
Tell us about the challenge to fight Cotto here in New York instead.
It's similar in ways. I'm going to have most of the crowd against me here, as I did when I was there in Germany. But it's nothing new to me, so I just need to go out and focus on myself. Don't worry about the crowd. I know if the crowd's not going crazy, if the crowd's not cheering and going wild, that's a good thing for me. So my idea is to keep quiet.
How do you feel? Are you really prepared?
I'm 100% prepared. We've done everything possible that we can. I came back to the U.S., had some great sparring from Gary Shores, a couple of Gary Shores fighters, and they've never been in a perfect mindset, physically and mentally.
Is it going to be a sure fight?
It's going to be a great fight. It'll be a great one to watch. Cotto. He always puts in a great fight, and he'll come. He'll want to fight hard, and I haven't come all this way and spent all this time away from my family.
Thank you.
Daniel, how do you feel about rebounding after that Golovkin fight? Being that a lot of his opponents, after they fight him, they're not really the same fighter as they once were.
Yeah, true. I feel like I am better from that fight. I learned a lot from that fight. I believe I didn't get pounded hard. I got caught, definitely. I got hurt, and caught. which happens in boxing. But, you know, I picked myself back up. I had a look at that tape a few times, and, you know, I believe I'm a better fighter for that. You know, sometimes when you have everything against you, it can get to you a little bit. Whereas, you know, if everything's against me this time, which, you know, I believe it probably will be, I'm ready for it. I'm ready for anything.
You think that was the best thing for you in that fight, for it to be early instead of, you know, guys that pull Golovkin have gone rounds, giving them fights, but the wear and tear from that fight is just, the rest of their careers aren't the same.
Yeah, I mean, he's a damaging fighter. I mean, he's very powerful, very damaging. You know, he's not only powerful, but you don't see too many guys that have the skills and everything else that back it all up. So, I mean, you know, I'd love another opportunity against him, and, you know, there has been some talk, so, you know, but my main focus is Miguel Cotto.
Is it going to be mildly strange? Golovkin is going to be on site at Barclays Center. It's going to be a little weird seeing him down there.
To be honest, I'm not going to see him.
Yeah.
I'm not looking out in the crowd. If he's there, you know, great stuff, but, you know, I'm focused on one person, and that's all.
Got it.
You have advantage by the weight?
That's why they made the weight at 157, to try and bring me down a little bit, but, you know, I will come back up. I will, you know, put that fluid back on. I'm losing fluid at the moment, but, you know, once I get the weighing out of the way, I'll bring that fluid back up, and I will be heavier, and I will use that as advantage, yes.
You're on track to make 157 a fight?
Yes.
Daniel, if you win, Canelo Alvarez could be a nice option for you?
I leave that to my team. I will focus on one person at this stage.
Dan, when you got caught by Golovkin, you went first. Are you willing to take a risk with Cotto, who's also a very heavy puncher?
Yeah, that's the way I fight. You know, I haven't come over here to dance around for 12 rounds. I've come over here to fight, and it's going to be an entertaining fight, this one. But in saying that as well, I have to use my best abilities against Cotto's. So obviously I'm not going to stand toe-to-toe and see who can punch hardest to the body. Because obviously Cotto, with his experience, he's going to have the advantage there. So I'm going to use my best skills against his. But I'm not coming over here to run and duck and hide and try and stay out of the way for 12 rounds. You know, I'm going to use what I can, and I will be successful at that. Thank you.
Daniel, you have a legendary nickname, Real Deal. Is that by coincidence, or is that inspired by Holyfield?
We don't use that nickname anymore.
No, not anymore?
No, no more.
Well, what's the new nickname?
Well, I'm waiting for you guys to come home with something.
Winner.
Hey, Geale, what can we expect out of you Saturday night? Step in the ring. What can we expect?
You can expect somebody that's, you know, learned from his experiences, grown as a fighter, and I'm here with a huge, huge opportunity. I'm fighting, a great fighter in Miguel Cotto, but also for the WBC ring titles, and, you know, this is what, you know, people dream of. So, you know, I haven't come over here just for a holiday. I've come over here 4 weeks beforehand, trained my butt off, and worked very, very hard, and now I'm very focused on this.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, everyone.
Thanks a lot.